So, folks, things keep on getting uglier for a person that ruined their life more than anyone for old Donnie, or at least it's debatable. When we talk about those that took their lives, took their reputations, whether they deserved it or not, and threw it in the toilet and flushed it down the drain, and then lit it on fire, Rudy Giuliani is at the top of the list. He's got to at least be in the running for number one. He didn't deserve all the credit he got in the last 20, 30 years, blah, 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 but he had it, and he burned it almost entirely through his association with Trump and the evil he did for Trump. And now he's in massive trouble, and as we've noted, there's this big lawsuit against him, but there was a critical detail revealed in many ways that absolutely changes everything. And about 15 minutes ago, breaking time, 15, 30 minutes ago, it just went criminal as Rudy Giuliani had his door kicked in and things have gotten very real very quickly. Listen to this. It explains how Rudy Giuliani is facing some criminal consequences and he is frozen in place like never before.
3,000 of his emails that he gave her his password. Really not that smart, Rudy. And he let her follow him around and videotape everything that he was saying. She has the receipts, baby.
She really does. And she filed a 70-page complaint in New York against him.
And when you read about the sexual acts he was doing, you're not going to believe this, how stupid
it's
he is.
It's so horrible. And just think about it. And he offered to pay her $1 million per year for consulting work, but told her that he had to defer paying her until he settled his divorce from his third wife, Judith. And she says that it was an opportunity that was too good to pass up. Sometimes when they sound too good.
So wait a minute. So she was servicing him.
Well,
because allegedly,
it's all going to come out. Whatever.
There was agreements made. One of them was his sexual urges would be met. There was he demanded sexual favors.
Allegedly.
For
$1 million.
While on the phone with high-profile friends, he'd make her work in shorts printed with an American flag. I mean, that's a red flag.
What
did he do with the flag?
He'd make her wear shorts printed with an American flag.
That's not the one that got me. What about the table?
Allegedly, whenever he took phone calls, sometimes when he allegedly took phone calls with high profile people, she needed to be working.
Lies
on the phone with Trump. Hello?
Under the table.
Allegedly.
This makes me sad because there was a time that Rudy Giuliani was America's mayor.
Here in New York, never America's mayor.
At least that's
tried to warn everybody
On the Republican side, at least, I felt like he tried to unite the city and the country after 9/11. He raised $216 million with the Twin Tower Fund. He was somebody that at one point was very esteemed, but things have dipped in the last few decades. This stuff never happens in a vacuum. If he was doing it now, he was probably doing it then. But where's his family? Melting
allegedly.
At the RNC, when his hair was melting at the RNC, why didn't his kids be like, hey, father, maybe get out of the public
eye? He's so repulsive, nobody even wants to tell him he's dripping.
I want to get to the issue, what you can tell us about what is recorded and what isn't. Repeatedly, you say in this complaint, this conversation was recorded, this statement was recorded. It doesn't say that when Giuliani's describing the way he's selling pardons for $2 million. Is there any recording about that?
There's not a recording about that that we know of. We do expect that it will be corroborated in other ways.
How else could that be corroborated?
Well, the complaint alleges that somebody else was present during those discussions, Lev Parnas. And in part, we would like to talk to him about those conversations.
So is it fair when you read these 69 pages that every place where it says this statement was recorded or anywhere it says this conversation was recorded, to interpret it as that's the recorded material? And wherever it doesn't say that, you can assume it's not recorded. That's the way I read it.
For the most part. But I would say that there are other recordings that were not referenced in the complaint that may become relevant at some time. You know, the complaint is an outline of Ms. Dunphy's allegations. It's a very detailed outline, yes. But there may be other evidence that comes out as the case proceeds towards trial.
Now, the lawsuit, to be clear, is about Rudolph Giuliani as described, luring this woman, a woman he finds attractive, into working for him, promising her to pay her $1 million a year, which he can't pay her right now because he's trying to hide money from his wife while he's in divorce proceedings. And if she just waits until the divorce is over, which is way more than the year in this story that is told, then she'll be paid retroactively all the money she's owed.
Exactly.
According to the lawsuit, she was never paid anything.
Well, she received a few small payments in cash so that they wouldn't be traceable. And she alleges that some of her business expenses were reimbursed, not all, but some. But the vast, vast majority of what she alleges was to be paid to her has never been paid.
The case is about these labor law violations of denial of wages. It's about sexual harassment in the workplace. It is about sexual assault in the workplace in this case. All this other information is packed into this lawsuit for, among other reasons, to actually prove that she did work for Giuliani, because Giuliani apparently is saying she was never an employee.
That's exactly right.
And if she's never an employee, then workplace sexual harassment laws don't apply.
That's what I understand his argument to be. I think that excuse is absurd. But looking at the level of detail in here and looking at what those details are, I think that it paints a very clear picture of somebody who's working for Giuliani.
And that's why all this information is in here about what they're communicating about. I mean, Giuliani is telling her, I'm selling pardons for $2 million, a million to me, a million to Donald. That's all a description that she's giving of her activity in the workplace, along with he gives her access, according to this complaint, to all of his email, 23,000 emails. He presses a button, transfers all of his emails to her computer so she can monitor emails for him because he doesn't read them all.
Right.
And she's got to tell him, here are the important ones. Among the emails you say she has read and is apparently still in possession of, well, Rudolph Giuliani would like you to know that he denies everything you're about to hear. He didn't actually deny it himself. He had a spokesperson put out a written statement today. Rudy Giuliani unequivocally denies the allegations raised by Ms. Dunphy. Ms. Dunphy is Noelle Dunphy, whose lawyer will join us in a moment. She has filed a lawsuit against Rudolph Giuliani, accusing him of extreme violations of labor law and sexual harassment law and laws against sexual assault. But the lawsuit, this lawsuit, right here, also quotes Rudolph Giuliani claiming that he was selling pardons for $2 million with the money to be split between himself and the issuer of the pardons, Donald Trump. That is by far the most serious evidence of federal crimes included in this lawsuit. The lawsuit also quotes Rudolph Giuliani telling Noelle Dunphy to commit the crime of lying to the FBI. That is also evidence of Rudy Giuliani committing another federal crime. And there is a third federal and state crime described in the lawsuit when Rudolph Giuliani is quoted describing how he collected $1 million owed to him without reporting it as income so that his wife would not be able to get any of that money in his then pending divorce proceedings. That is federal income tax evasion, which carries a 5-year prison term, and state income tax evasion. And so there are 4 major crimes identified in this lawsuit that are worthy of federal investigation. 3 of those possible federal crimes described as committed by Rudolph Giuliani, and a 4th describes Rudolph Giuliani and Donald Trump co-conspiring to commit the federal crime of extortion, $2 million for a Trump pardon. The problem, the big problem for Rudolph Giuliani and his written blanket denial of everything in this 69-page lawsuit filed in Manhattan today is the sentence, this conversation was recorded, which appears repeatedly throughout this document. The conversation about splitting bribe money, extortion money, with Donald Trump was not recorded. It appears on page 26 of the lawsuit complaint, just above the passage that shows an actual text message from Rudolph Giuliani to Noel Dunphy asking, can I shower with you? Perfectly normal question for boss Rudy Giuliani, one of his employees. At the top of that same page, the complaint says he also asked Ms. Dunphy if she knew anyone in need of a pardon, telling her that he was selling pardons for $2 million, which he and President Trump would split. He told Ms. Dunphy that she could refer individuals seeking pardons to him so long as they did not go through the normal channels of the Office of Pardon Attorney, because correspondence going to that office would be subject to disclosure under the Freedom of Information Act. A footnote, just a footnote on page 39 says he told her that if the FBI sought to interview her, she should not remember anything and should claim that she did not know Giuliani. Ms. Dunphy refused to agree to lie to the FBI, which angered Giuliani. If Rudy Giuliani did say that, that is a federal crime. There is no indication that that conversation was recorded. As for the tax crime alleged in this lawsuit, it appears that defendant Giuliani has a very big problem. On page 22 of the complaint, it says Giuliani told Ms. Dunphy that someone owed him $1 million, but Giuliani hinted that instead of having the money paid to him, he had his friend Robert Strick hold it for him. He said, Robert Strick just got me a $1 million payment. This statement was recorded.